no crucifixion, no resurrection. He was put on the cross and brought down very fast in 3 hours. In 3 hours, it's difficult for a person to die. Therefore, Jesus was alive. When he's brought down, even his two cross mates, they are alive, proving that even Jesus was alive. Point number two. Point number three, his legs were not broken. What use is a broken leg to a dead man? Proving that he was alive. Point number four, that the stone was removed and the winding sheets were unbound, proving that Jesus, peace be upon him, was alive. Point number five, that he was disguised as a gardener. Why? Because he was alive, trying to be saved from the Jews. Point number six, the tomb was roomy. It was spacious. What use is a spacious tomb for a dead person? Proving Jesus was alive. Point number seven, that when Mary Magdalene goes to touch Jesus, peace be upon him, he says, touch me not. Why? He was a physical body. He was alive. It will hurt him. He was in pain, proving that he was alive. Jesus, peace be upon him, says that I have not yet ascended unto my Father. That means he was alive. Point number nine, Mary Magdalene, not after recognizing Jesus, peace be upon him. Point number 10, that in the upper room, he shows his hands and feet to prove that he was not a spirit, but he was alive. Point number 11, that they were overjoyed to see him. Why? Because they thought he's dead and the spirit form. They were overjoyed to see because he was alive. Point number 12, he ate a piece of broiled fish and honeycomb to prove that he was alive. The disciples had heard from Mary Magdalene that he was alive. Point number 14, the sign of Jonah. As Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the whale, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. Alive, alive, alive. If he's alive, no crucifixion, no resurrection. So in short, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was put on the cross, according to the Bible, but he did not die. Now, the topic is, was Christ really crucified? If he's put on the cross and if he dies, he's crucified. If he's put on the cross and does not die, what is one word that we'll use? See, English language is deficient. If you look up in the dictionary for a word, for a person who's put on the cross but does not die, you will not find any word. So we have to coin new word. The best word that we can coin is that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was not crucified, but he was crucifixed. It is not crucifixion, C-R-U-C-I-F-I-X-I-O-N, but it is crucifixion, C-R-U-C-I-F-I-C-T-I-O-N. It's affixion. We have to coin a new word. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was not crucifixed, he was crucifixed. So I hope this ends the friction, and the pastor will agree, and the confusion will be removed from his mind, that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was not crucified. There is no crucifixion, F-I-X-I-O-N, but crucifixion, F-I-C-T-I-O-N. I'd like to end my talk by giving the quotation of the glorious Quran from Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 54, which says, وَمَكَرُوا مَكَرَ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. They planned and plotted. Allah too planned. Allah is the best of planner. وَآخْرُ دَعْوَانَ